Dooley Noted, 6-6-2016. Hi, I'm Dr. Kathy Dooley. I'm here on my day off at Breakneck Ridge here in New York. And I wanted to show you, along with a beautiful panoramic view, I wanted to show you some things that I saw in multi-segmental extension or an overhead reach in a lot of my patients that may set you up for back pain or even leave you at risk for things like disc herniation. Let me show you what I mean. When people overhead reach and lean back, a lot of them will lean back on one segment. It looks a little bit like this, but they'll keep their hips relatively fixed and they'll lean back on one segment. So you have 24 vertebrae and also a sacrum along with hips that can actually help you share that load. That would look like this. A lot of people lack the ability to move through their thoracic spine freely like this, and they lack the ability to move freely through their hips like this. What that ends up doing to the spine is it ends up putting all the force on one segment. And sometimes that happens at the TL junction where the ribs actually meet the end of the vertebrae here at T12L1, or they'll end up hinging at your most susceptible spot for disc herniations in the low back, that's L4, L5, L5S1, or they'll hinge here. To teach yourself how to better load share and extension, what you can do is standing anywhere you are, whether you're hiking, whether you're going anywhere, standing in a line, what you can do is do something called the sacral nudge, something made popular by McKenzie. Robin McKenzie was a physical therapist, and you can just push the sacrum forward, not letting your low back move. Try that. If it's exacerbatory for pain, then just limit your range of motion and try to just encourage the sacrum to move forward. What you're gonna feel is your weight shift across the surface of your foot and even to the front of the forefoot just a little bit more than you might expect. After you do that, you can bring your hands up, as long as it doesn't hurt your shoulders, to right between your shoulder blades and try to encourage that movement, but keeping the lumbar spine relatively fixed. Try to prevent leaning into your low back. Just move through the thorax. What I tell people is bring the sternum forward. If you're hearing popping and clicking in your shoulders, it's because you're moving through your shoulder girdle too much. Try to leave that fixed and just move your sternum forward. It might feel very, very stiff. And then what you'll do is combine them together. Sternum forward, sacral nudge. What you'll start to notice when you do this is that you're now load sharing between multiple segments, hips, sacrum, and more vertebrae. For people that use the neck too much, they like to do sometimes a hinge through here and then try to pull their neck backwards. For me in particular, that's something I was prone to doing. So what you can do is just encourage the neck to relax as you pull the sternum forward, and then you can take a hand down and nudge the sacrum forward. Before you know it, you'll have multi-segmental load share. These are really great for people that are extension intolerant, people that don't like cobra positions, or when they're in pranayama, they get a little bit of neck discomfort. It's a yoga pose. So consider multi-segmental load sharing in extension. If you're feeling back discomfort in extension, it's probably because your low back is moving too much. You need to limit it and start to move other parts. Dr. Kathy Dooley, I hope this is helpful. I'll see you next time.